We've always wondered what happened to the guns that were salvaged from Vasa. There are only three of Vasa's guns left in the museum, the ones still on board the ship when it was recovered or found in 1956. And we know that most of the guns were recovered by salvers in the 17th century, primarily a partnership between Albrecht von Treileben and Andreas Peckel, who used a diving bell and a crane to recover most of the ship's guns in 1663 to 1665. We always wondered what had happened to those. We know from historic source material that they had been exported, headed for Germany, but we really lose track of them after that. And in a discussion with the British ambassador and his wife, David and Sharon Cairns, a couple of years ago, we were talking about that whole question about what might have happened. And I had just come back from a year of research in England, where I'd found a reference in the British Admiralty archives, or actually their Board of Ordnance archives, that they had purchased 40 24-pounder cannon from Sweden in the spring of 1665, which was just at the point when Albrecht von Treileben was exporting 40 24-pounder cannon from Sweden. That coincidence seemed too strong to ignore. So I mentioned this to David and Sharon, and Sharon said, well, why don't we go find them? Shouldn't it be possible to see if those cannons still exist? So it was really her idea that sparked this whole idea. And then her husband, David, the ambassador, took an interest in it. He contacted the Dutch ambassador, Inez Koppelse, who also took an interest because we think those are the two most likely candidates who bought the guns, because a colleague of mine in the Netherlands found a reference that at about the same time, the Dutch were buying cannon of the same type from Sweden. And the Dutch and the English were at war then, and they both needed cannon. And so it seemed a little odd that there are two consignments of guns of the same type that were raised from Vasa being sold out of Sweden at that same time. And Andreas Albrecht von Treileben, the entrepreneur who had organized the project to raise the guns, he was exactly the kind of shady businessman who would have managed or tried to sell the guns twice to competing owners. So out of that grew the idea, well, why don't we see if there's a way to look for these guns to find out what really happened to them.